the Southwest. But we are glad to have those of you who've come from Alaska with us today. I know you've traveled a long way and taken a lot of time to be here for this special event. But it's also important to know that this event is being webcast. And David Boxley, who obviously is the grand artist of this magnificent work of art, tells me that his village is watching back in Alaska. And so we welcome them to this event as well. We're all supposed to wave to them. This is obviously a special event for us. I had the great opportunity to meet David and his dance troupe in Anchorage when we opened the new wing to the Anchorage Museum about 2 years ago. And it was a fantastic event then. And so it's a special day to reunite with David and his family and his dance troupe here in Washington, D.C. David's troupe was the first to dance on that floor when this building was opened. So there's a long history that goes back to his family. This work of art is a magnificent one. Not only is it a great work of art by a great master and his sons, but it tells an enormous story, which I'm sure you've read about. David, I must say, it's not only that this work of art is not only a beautiful piece, but Kevin, this has to be one of the largest and heaviest pieces of art that we've ever accessed into the Smithsonian. So we thank you for what you've done, and we thank you for bringing this to us today and to share with all the American people and the people of the world. Thank you, Kevin.
How many of you have seen a totem pole before? Of course you have. What you may not know is that each totem pole tells a story. And the totem pole that you're going to see in just a few moments tells a special story, which we'll ask David to share with you because it is a story from the Tsimshian culture. But each totem pole tells a story. Perhaps it will tell the story of a particular family. It may tell the story of an entire community. It may be a story of myth and legend. And anything that tells a story has a home here at the National Museum of the American Indian, because that's what we do here, is tell stories. We tell old stories, we tell new stories. We tell stories about people from many different places, having many different ways, many different practices, many different religions. And no matter who you are, this is your museum. And no matter who you are, the stories that we tell here are your stories as well. What we've attempted to do at the National Museum of the American Indian is to create a place where all people can come together as human beings and talk about what kind of world we can make for our children. So without further ado, I'm going to ask Dr. Club to help me unveil this newest addition to our museum.
Carver's dance, and in doing this carver's dance,